नेस्टेड लूप्स. नेस्टेड लूप इज एंटायरली अनदर कॉन्सेप्ट. नेस्टिंग कैन बी परफॉर्म्ड विद इन वाइल लूप और फॉर लूप और फॉर विद इन वाइल और वाइल विद इन फॉर. सो दिस कॉन्सेप्ट इज कॉल्ड नेस्टेड लूप्स. व्हेन वी राइट वन लूप इनसाइड अनदर लूप देन दैट कॉन्सेप्ट इज कॉल्ड नेस्टिंग ऑफ लूप्स. सो इट इज परफॉर्म्ड. लेट्स सी फॉर वैल इन सीक्वेंस. फॉर वैल इन सीक्वेंस दैट मीन्स दिस इज आउटर फॉर लूप एंड दिस इज इनर वन. These are the statements associated with the inner one, and these are the statements associated with the outer one. So this is outer for loop, and this is inner for loop. This is the journal syntax. So let's understand through a program as well. Similarly, this is the syntax for while loop. While test condition, while test condition. So this is outer for loop, outer while loop, and this is inner while loop. Fine. We can put while within while or for within for, or we can also write for inside while or while inside for also. Every possibility is possible. Now let's understand a program of nesting of loops for loop where we want to compute factorial of first n natural numbers where the value of n is input by the user. So we'll print factorial of all the numbers starting from 1 up to n. Whatever the number user enters, it will compute factorial up to that number. So let's see how it works. Suppose n is equal to input, enter a number. We have input a number. Let's suppose that number is 8. Now, for I in range 1 comma n plus 1, that means the loop will grow from 1 to 8, 1 to 9, n plus 1. That means we have mentioned here n plus 1 because we want the list should be processed or range function will go up to exactly 8 because the input number is 8. So we have mentioned 1 to 8 and we have set the factorial value initially to 1 and then in the inner loop, we'll compute the factorial. For j in range I 1 comma I plus 1. So initially the initial point is 1 and ending point is, since I's value is initially 1, it will go up to 2. And then we'll compute f is equal to f into j. That means f is equal to 1 into 1 because the value of both f is 1 and j is also 1. This is f and this is j. F will become 1. The loop will go up and this will become false because it will go up to 1 only as it is 2 over here. I already told you it goes up to 1 number less than the specified number. So loop will become false and it will print after this statement. It will become false and then it will come out of this and it will print factorial of dash 0 is 1. These are placeholders, which we have understood in the formatting chapter also. The value of I will be put over here and value of F will be substituted over here. So I value is 1 and F value is also 1. So the output will be displayed as factorial of 1 is 1. Fine. Then the loop will go up again to the outer one and the value of I will be augmented to 2. Let me write here clearly. It is up to 9. Now I will become 2. It will go inside. F will be set as 1 again. And it will run for j in range 1 comma 3. That means the loop will run twice. One and two. For two values, 1 and 2. And F will be computed as F is equal to F into j. Earlier value of f is 1 and the value of j is also 1 and the loop will be augmented. Now j will become 2, 2. Then it will become 3 and the loop will become false and control will go here. It will print factorial of 2 is 2 and it will go to the outer loop. Now the value of I will become 3. Now the inner loop will go from 1 to 4. 1 to 4. And let me erase this also. It will confuse you. Now loop will go from 1 to 3. Initially J is 1. So it will be computed as F into 1, 1. Then 1 into J will become 2, 2. Next time 2 into J will become 3 because the value are varying like this. J value will be initially 1, 2 and 3 for this loop. 1, 2 and 3. It will become 6. Next time it will become 4 and the loop will be false. And it will go out of the loop and print factorial of 0 is 1 dot format I comma F. The value of I is 2, our value of I is 3 and F value is computed to be 6. So this third statement will be printed. Similarly, the next iteration, it will go one more step. It will be 6 into 4 because the range will be 1 comma 5, 24. So this statement will be printed and so on. By this way, all the 8 statements and 8 factorials will be computed and we'll get the output like this. So the basic concept to learn over here is nesting of for loop, where we have used this inner for loop for computing the factorial and outer for loop is used to augment the number one by one. See, this is being augmenting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 by the outer for loop. And this answer is being computed by the inner for loop. So this is how we can use nesting of loops to get our results or answers. So this is all about nesting of for loop. So this is all about for loop and nesting of for loops. In the next lecture, we'll study control statements.